Hi, welcome to this UAS tutorial brought to you by AmericaView. This is Malcolm Williamson from the Center for Advanced Spatial Technologies at the University of Arkansas. Today we'll be looking at some custom tools and workflows that we have created to help process data from the FLIR Duo R thermal / RGB camera. The FLIR Duo R offers calibrated thermal data at a very reasonable price point. However, if you're interested in creating an orthomosaic of the thermal data to analyze over a large area, you'll find that the very limited resolution of the thermal sensor will prevent you from being able to accomplish this with off-the-shelf photogrammetry software. Our team has developed an approach that enables alignment of the thermal data based upon the accompanying higher resolution RGB images using ArcGIS Desktop version 10.3 or higher with the Spatial Analyst Extension and Atrasoft Photoscan Professional. Although the solution may not be robust enough to satisfy photogrammetrists in the audience, it produces a usable product that retains the original thermal data values of the raw data. We have produced an ArcGIS toolbox that contains four different model builder tools that are used to pre-process the Duo R data before photogrammetric processing, as well as a single post-processing tool. This toolbox, along with instructions, can be found at this web link. We have chosen to use ArcGIS simply because we have ready access to it. It should be possible to duplicate this process in other GIS software, such as QGIS, or even to code it in an environment such as Python, which has a wide range of image processing libraries. In this video, we'll look at the primary steps involved to run these tools on a sample data set from the Duo R. During the flight, a time interval was set on the Duo R to collect thermal and RGB still images with approximately 80% overlap. All of these RGB and thermal images from the camera are now saved to a single folder on my working computer. Note the JPEG files containing the RGB data and the TIFF files containing the thermal data. As I go back one folder level, note that there are also two files containing georeflinks data. More on that a bit later. I'm also going to create two new folders for this project, one called RGB16 and one called Thermal16. Before we start the process, let's look at the raw data in Arcmap. Here is one pair of RGB and thermal images. Note that the thermal image is much lower resolution than the RGB and doesn't align at all with it. We'll soon fix that. We'll start with the first tool in the thermal camera toolbox, Copy Thermal. This tool simply copies the 16-bit TIFFs into the new Thermal16 folder as 16-bit.img files, necessary for later processing. The Step 2 tool, Transform 8-bit to 16-bit, converts the 8-bit per band JPEGs to 16-bit 3-band TIFFs in the new RGB16 folder, as it's necessary to have both sets of images at the same bit depth. The Step 3 tool, Align Thermal Images, uses the ArcGIS georeferencing tools to align each thermal image with its matching RGB image. We provide a link table in our downloads that does a decent job aligning data from the two sensors in our particular camera. You may need to modify the link to best match yours. This is detailed in the instructions. Here is a pair of images after the alignment. Once the individual pairs of images are aligned, the Step 4 tool, Composite RGB and GeoRef Thermal, simply creates 16-bit 4-band composite TIFFs from the RGB and thermal images. Now you're ready to import the new composites from the Thermal16 folder into Atrasoft Photoscan Professional. When you first add photos to Photoscan, they will all appear black. Double-click on one of the photos to open it, then open the Image Brightness tool in the Photo menu. Click the Estimate button and then Apply. All the images should now appear as histogram-equalized panchromatic images. If you want to add ground control points, it should now be possible. Otherwise, run the Align Photos tool in high accuracy, then Build Dense Cloud in high quality. Build a mesh using a height field surface type. Finally, when creating the orthomosaic, be sure to set the blending mode to disabled and don't enable color correction. Export your orthomosaic as a TIFF. Switch back to ArcMap and use the Step 5 tool, Fix Orthos, to split your 4-band mosaic into an 8-bit 3-band RGB mosaic and a 16-bit thermal mosaic. You can now process or symbolize your thermal data to best suit your needs. I hope you find this useful. Please contact me if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.